House, Black C, Mr. C, R.B.L. Posse, in the house of some of that old smooth shit. You know what I'm saying? Some shit you can kick back to with a dang sack. You know what I'm saying? Get straight two-took. You know what I'm saying? So while you kick back getting two-took, let my boy take this little story for you. What is fuck? I just finished grinding. I peeped at my watch, I had some spare time. So I told Black Chris, let's jump in the fire to find us a bitch. But don't forget, niggas gotta get their girth bone. So we rode a cashmere to grab a fat sack of Endo. Then Black Chris said, where should we start? And at the same time, two hoes dipped up in a lark. I roll a freak, that's how I called it. They was rolling on government, so they had to be balling. I told Black Chris to stop with the quickness, cause both of them hotties had a case of the thickness.
What?
Niggas know what I mean, no fat at all, just 100% beef that was lean. There was no problem when it came to the choosing, cause whoever they picked, they sure wasn't losing out, without a doubt. Cause Frisco niggas got a lot of clout. We jumped out the car, one screamed R.B.L. The other looked and said, ooh, oh yeah. Right then, I knew it would be easy, cause both of them hoes was anxious, two-star skeezing. Chris asked the freaks, where were they from? They said Richmond, and they was looking for some fun. Well, they had a jump start on the other hoes, cause they was with two poppin' niggas from the town of Frisco, so you know we had to do this shit right. Bought an eighth the day and got them drunk off the act right. Off to the freakies, here we go, here we go. It's Frisco's version of a sex sideshow, but the only ride done was on my dick. I already got a crew, so I don't fuck with no clicks. In plain words, if you lost, I don't do no licking, cause I'm straight for the toss. Pulled out my ding dong, commenced the school. Since I was younger, she thought I didn't know what I was doing. But like a vet, I took control, sorta like Joe Montana winning a Super Bowl. My rice aroni, the San Francisco cheap, but she didn't get hooked on no rice. She got hooked on this meat. Chris got me up about 11 o'clock. He said we gotta go to Harvard to sell off our rock. Ain't got no time to play Captain Save a Ho, just to send a few numbers so we can G.O. Mr. C got the number, and my freak said, is this real or are we on the under? Would I ever call or would I just diss her? I told her like this so I can remember.
But you don't really hear me though, so let's jump to
to the next situation. Hitting it from the side, letting out my frustration. Sweat all through the night. I was fucking till morning, so I worked up an appetite. Plus it was time to go, so I called Mr. C in the room next door. Hello. Hey, Mr. C, man, let's be up, man. Fuck that shit, I'm gonna be Bunder 5000.
Alright. Then we said bye, we were on our way. Hungry as fuck, punching straight to B&J's. And that's how the day ended. I called her freak once, but she didn't get offended. She said, I understand where you're coming from. You a star now, and only little time to have fun. But I'll be faithful and patient, cause when I see it, it's gonna be a special occasion. We saw each other off and on. The summer passed and she went back home, home to New York City. But then I met her aunts, and they looked like twins. She, her aunt was 20 years old, but let's face it, her auntie really had it going on. Ain't no mission to what I was doing. Until this day, that bitch in me is still scoring. You might say Mr. C is scandalous, but she gave up the action, so I took advantage, cause I'm not going to New York City. So don't blame me for making her aunt.